Hi, I'm Dr. John Kugler with the Stanford 25 Ultrasound Series. So far we've already learned how to do a volume assessment where we measured the CVP by visualizing the IVC. But to do a really comprehensive volume assessment, I want to show you all how we can layer in a few more things. Now, obviously, any volume assessment is going to involve our physical exam, as well as taking in the patient's history and other sort of clinical markers. So we can imagine I've already checked to see if the patient has obvious leg edema. I may have already looked to see if there's ascites here. But now I'm going to use the ultrasound to improve my ability to assess his volume status. So normally, I would assess his neck veins visually. And that works really well for a lot of patients. But we know that visual assessment of the neck veins doesn't work in as many as 40% of patients, whether their neck anatomy just doesn't allow it, they've got an obese neck, maybe a big beard. But we just know that for a lot of people, you just can't see the neck veins. So if you're one of those people that struggles, join the club. It's not always that easy. So I'm going to show you how we can use ultrasound to complete this. Now again, a comprehensive volume assessment, we're going to use our physical exam. We're going to look at the IVC as we talked about earlier. We're going to look for pleural effusions as we talked about. We're also going to look for B-lines. We're going to put all these things together, and then the final thing we'll do is layer in the JVP. I think if you do this, if you bring all of that clinical information to bear, you're much more likely to have an accurate assessment of the patient's central venous pressure. So let's go about looking at the neck veins. Now, some of you may have already done this when you place a central line. So it's going to be a really similar type exam in terms of what you need to visualize. But I am going to add that today, we want to see where do the neck veins collapse, right? We're going to be looking just as if we were measuring the height of the JVP visually, except now I'm going to use the ultrasound to visualize the vein. What I'm going to look for is when the vein goes from being wide to where it comes together, all right? Now, I'm going to make sure I've got my dot on the correct side here. Good. And so you can have the patient. I like actually having the patient sitting up. It makes it a little easier just to separate things out. Okay, you can even have them sitting bolt upright for this. Just know that, again, their neck veins may be pretty low when you do that, okay? You don't need to have them turn their head as much for this exam like you would when you're visualizing. He's fine with just a neutral position, okay? Now, I'm going to place my probe where I believe the IVC is going to be, and we can see already his is already pretty collapsed, even here. Now, watch what happens when I look down. Now I can see that it's pretty open, okay? Now, the challenge with this exam, and this is the only technically difficult part, is even light pressure with my probe will collapse the vein. And, of course, that's not telling you what you want to know. So I'm just going to show you how that works. So here's light pressure, right? And now watch what happens when I push. Now it looks like it's totally collapsed again, right? But that's me pressing too hard. So, again, when you go to do this exam, this is where you can mess it up. You need to have gentle pressure. Even the lightest pressure can totally collapse. So we can see here, as we move up, his vein is totally collapsed. And then here we come down, and we can see it's nice and open, okay? So we can say with certainty that our patient's neck veins are right here at his clavicle. They're not elevated. Now, if you were unsure, right, we could always lay the patient down more and really fine-tune this a little bit. But in almost every situation, this is easy and it's good enough. And you can see it only took a few seconds to measure. And so again, if you're struggling visualizing the JVP, think about using your ultrasound. The only other thing I'll add is you notice we used a linear probe here. So again, when you're thinking about how you might do this in real life, you do need to have a linear probe with you to do this ultrasound well. And some people are only carrying a cardiac probe. It's not going to work with a cardiac probe. You really want to have a linear probe so you can clearly visualize the vein.